Hello, my beautiful Cancers. How are you today? Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna. We're getting ready to do your love reading. So let's look and see, Cancer, for you, what the overall energy is in this love reading. Hope everyone's doing well. Happy holidays. Let's see. Here we go. Cancer, Justice card. Ooh, I love the Justice card for a love reading. Because when we get the Justice card for a love reading, it means that you could be moving in together, buying a home together, getting married, anything that requires the legal paperwork involved in partnership. So we do have a situation here. The overall energy is somebody has been sort of manipulative or toxic in the relationship. We do have the Seven of Swords not coming clean. Somebody needs to tell the truth. So in the recent past, you and your beloved have had some sort of falling out or argument, something very unpleasant. You feel as though there's like blood in the water, you know, sort of Jaws. That's my Jaws impression. But it certainly shows that it's been a painful experience for you. We have the Seven of Wands. Currently, both of you are thinking about each other a lot. I'm getting the energy that you're both very defensive. You really feel as though there was a lot of conflict. You're holding your own, but it does show a certain level of sadness here. But you're standing in your power, Cancer. That's you especially. And then we have the Scorpio King here. Scorpio season just ended. We still have Mars there. So it is the Scorpio King is somebody who hides their emotions, who appears very calm on the surface, but very much a person who's been through a stormy time in this relationship. And that's how they see the relationship, something that came to an end. But Scorpio is all about death and rebirth. This is Capricorn energy here, Libra energy, and the Seven of Swords is Aquarius energy. So your person's trying to figure out how to sneak back in is what I'm seeing. Okay, so what else do we have here? How do they view you? They see you as someone, Cancer, that's your energy. They see you as someone who would be really disengaged and rather upset with them. They see you as feeling sad, feeling lonely, not sure what happened. In their heart space, they're feeling like they want to nurture the relationship. The Queen of Pentacles energy is the mommy card. That is a desire to reach out, to establish contact, to the desire to stabilize a relationship and nurture it. Three of Swords, okay. So the way they see the relationship moving forward is getting out of this energy of heartbreak. The Three of Swords it also is telling me that they could have had some sort of situation with a third party, but it is just straight up heartbreak is the meaning of the card. So they feel as though the two of you have been in separation for at least 3 months. They're not sure it can be healed. The energy that's hidden between the two of you, Eight of Cups, there's a sense that you didn't have any other choice other than to walk away. It does show the sun, though, walking to the sun. What is spirit advising you? Stay in your power. Stand in your power. You're highly desirable, Cancer. You're supposed to be, you know, look good, feel good, you know, build on your stability. Keep yourself very stable as a single person for right now. And we have the Two of Swords not speaking. All right, we are going to clarify this reading. This is for those of you who are currently in separation, as what it looks like, without a doubt here. So if you're not in separation with this person or you haven't gone for a period without speaking, I would say this is unlikely to be a reading. So let's see why the Justice card is here. Why is the Justice card here for our Cancer friends? Six of Cups. Ooh, the desire for reunion. That is the overall energy of this relationship reading. Six of Cups is Scorpio energy, and Scorpio's death and rebirth. So we've seen the death of the relationship, you know, in terms of with the Scorpio King. These cards indicate that you're not in contact, you're not speaking. So it shows that we have the energy that both of you are feeling that way. What else do we have here? What is the Devil card here? Being in suspension. Somebody was very toxic in this energy. Somebody was very unkind. You feel as though you might have taken, it's like a cartoon character who takes a knockout punch to the head, seeing stars and not the good ones. So it does show that you feel like you were manipulated, feels that there probably was a manipulation. There was certainly dishonesty in what happened here. Four of Cups. Somebody was taking you for granted, not really accepting the idea of a firm love relationship with you. They were not telling you that. Three of Coins. The energy, though, now is that they would like to chat with you. The energy also now for the Hanged Man and the Devil card is that your person would like to speak to you, take some authority in the situation. There is fire in the belly for reunion. All right, so let's see why we have the Five of Swords here. Five of Swords is a card that says, I'm going to win by picking up all the swords that you drop on the ground, Cancer. Wheel of Fortune, so it does look like you're coming out of that period of time. You know, definitely in the energy of, you know, it's fortune's turning in your favor. They do see, your person sees you as very fiery, very sexy. They definitely want to reach out. They feel as, oh my gosh, look at these cards. They see you as a rock star. They see you as a rock star with whom they should have made a commitment. Happily ever after relationship. Your person is feeling remorse and regret. That Five of Swords is an unhappy card, but that person brought it on themselves in the relationship. Seven of Wands, why are you feeling defensive? Well, you are worn out. And you feel, you know, you don't know what's coming up here, so of course you would feel defensive. Now, it is a mutual energy, so your person doesn't really know what you're going to say to them, but they're thinking that they didn't behave very well, so it probably wouldn't be, you know, one of great love, but here you have it. Both of you love each other. Your current mutual energy is Lance romance. Let's have a night of romance. And that is all about emotions. That's about your feelings. That's not about just passion or bed. That's emotions. Look at this. Your person wants to make you an offer. And here we go, the Scorpio King. The butterfly is a rebirth. After the death, the flower blooms again. And so your person wants to reach out to you. They want to make an offer. Very strong Scorpio energy here for you. Somebody's feeling the pain, the wounds, the, you know, they're getting their own karma here. All right, why do we have the Four of Cups here in your energy? We have the Nine of Cups. You're their happy place. That's how they feel about you. They just feel as though you represent a lot of laughter, a lot of joy. They remember those times with you. They feel very much that you are their soulmate. And here we go. They broke your heart. Five of Swords. They were ugly. There's something that they did with that was very treacherous. You know, drawing blood. You know, blood in the water. I mean, you really got hurt from this, Cancer. The Turtle card. They've been alone for a while. That Hermit card is searching for answers. And that is a card of being alone and recognizing the damage they did in this relationship. Why is the Eight of Cups here? You've left each other behind. The Strength card, not surprising. You have fire in your belly. This is Leo energy wanting to have the strength to come back together. You do have the courage to do it. Tell us something else about the Eight of Cups. The Heart of Cups. Okay, so Queen of Cups energy, Cancer. There you are in your reading. The way I'm reading this, Cancer, is your person was really raw with you. They were very manipulative. They weren't honest. They broke your heart. They weren't kind. Let's see what else we have, but you love them. The Judgment card is your advice from Spirit. Call this person. They have to pay their karmic debt to you. You don't give them anything more unless they come clean with you. They have to pay their karma. They have to tell you why they left you in the cold. They have to come clean and they have to own it. Yes, they have to show you exactly why you should take them back, why they're worthy of it, because the Moon card, Pisces energy, you may be dealing with a Pisces, but it really speaks to the fact that they left you in the dark. They broke your heart. Let's see what else we have. and they want a new beginning. So Spirit is saying, don't let them come back in unless they come back in right. And you know what, Cancer? I don't see you letting them back in that easily anyway. They have some major, they have a lot of wounds to heal. They have to earn back their credibility. They have to earn back your trust. They have to explain what they did. The Ace of Wands, fire in their belly. Oh, they have fire in their belly. They want to talk to you. They are feeling very confused. This is, you know, they're trying to figure out why they kept their options open when you were very clearly a soulmate and a happily ever after to them. The Heart of Swords, they see you as a person in Judge Judy energy that, you know, really you have no rational reason to want to let this person back in. And it is making a head over heart decision. They're not sure what you're going to do if they reach out, but they are definitely at a crossroads. So that is really, that's, they have to reach out. So what will they do? Eight of Cups are still not feeling confident. The Eight of Cups. They have to walk away from something else. The Page of Swords looks like they're going to check you out on the World Wide Web. But the Ten of Swords, this is a lot of explaining. For some of you, it could mean that the person is just really not going to be able to give you what you need and want. But the Ace of Swords, they do have clarity. They do know what they're supposed to bring to the table. Let's look and see what the energy is here with the Heart of the Fairy Oracle, because this is a very negative outcome for the fact that your person wants to come back. I don't think they're quite ready. I would say you're looking at, you have an Ace of Coins. We go to the final card and it's an ace. It could be any day. Worst case scenario would be 8 weeks is what I'm seeing. 8 to 10 weeks, 2 months. Okay. So what is the energy here to clarify the overall hurt that you've experienced? Yeah, the juggler. So this person was juggling. They were juggling people, places, things, situations. Very tricky card. The juggler is the trickster and not the good one. Very toxic, okay? We get the Queen of Passage. They put you through a dark night of the soul energy. You know, you're looking at that apple going, well, if I take a bite, is it poison? You know, I don't really know. Queen of the Night, they left you very much in the dark. They really know that they've done this. Let's see. Oops, that went flying somewhere. I'm not sure where. Oh, well, oh, there it is. Be right back. Hold on. I flew under the table to the back. All right, so it's important. Oh, wonderful. Okay. This is explaining to me why they want to come back. You are the Lady of Leprechauns. You are a person who is very, very attractive to them. They see you as unusual, as interesting, as fun, as playful, as joyful. And the Lady of the Leprechauns loves a human male lover. So there's something, some aspect of your sensuality and sexuality that this person found really enticing. Okay. So now let's look here. So your person is coming back. I mean, they are coming back, but they're scattered. Let's see, what are they going to actually offer you? What will they offer you upon arrival? Upon arrival, what will they offer you? Because they want the new beginning with the Fool card. They want to offer you stability, okay. That would be a far cry from where you were at before. Power, okay. They want the power to give you, you know, what you need, what you want energetically. They want to be still so that you're the only person. They want to make sure that they can give you the best knowledge. Okay, they want to come back with more wisdom and transcending. There we go, Pegasus energy. So that's really the key. Whether you let them back in, Cancer, is going to be up to you. This person really crossed some dark boundaries here. They look like they would have been a very tough person to have dealt with recently, or, you know, however long it's been for those of you who are here in the reading. So I am broadcasting from Chicago. please let me know on the comments below where you're watching this from, and sending you love. Talk to you soon, Cancer. Bye-bye.